Lois, finally.
What?
Well, I've been trying to find you.
Oh, here I am. What's up?
What's that thing called, you know, when a loan finally comes through on your house and all of a sudden you're a homeowner and you realize what you've done?
Well, buyer's remorse?
Exactly.
Brenda, what did you do? I mean, having confidence in our ability to run a major record label is one thing, but don't you think it's a little too soon to start making major purchases?
What are you talking about?
You just said you bought a house.
No, I didn't. I was making an analogy.
All right. Let's start this thing all over again, shall we? What seems to be the problem?
The problem is Sonny. I've been sitting here worrying all day about his money. Now, are you going to talk to him or what?
Done. Right after you left, I drove down to Port Charles and Sonny and I took a meeting. Don't you just love that industry lingo? Anyway, I am fully reassured, professionally speaking.
Lois, listen to me. Sonny can be very convincing when he wants to be. God, I mean, how can you be sure that the money he's using to finance L&B is clean?
All right, okay? Put it this way, Brenda. I have absolutely no desire to speculate as to what Sonny's been into before our little record label, okay?
But he has convinced me that he has his own reasons for wanting a legit operation, and we happen to be it. He's got something we want, and we got something he wants. And he's too smart to put it at risk. The rest, I don't ask.
So you're really, really sure?
Yes. Look, I would be all over him like a cheap suit if I had any doubts.
Our collective future is uppermost on my list of priorities.
Okay. Well, there's one problem solved at least.
Oh, wait. Bet you I can guess the other problem.
What am I going to do, Lois?
Can't help you there, girlfriend. Only you can prevent forest fires.